exchange in my conversation with Sudan's former foreign minister, Mariam Almahdi, joins me now live from Khartoum. And Mariam, thank you very much for taking time to speak to us. As you've been seeing and we've been reporting, we've seen diplomats, foreign nationals being evacuated, Mariam. For ordinary Sudanese, this must be incredibly stressful as well as frustrating when you're seeing this. Your thoughts this hour, Mariam?
Well, thank you very much, Isa. I am personally, as a former Minister of Foreign Affairs, I have been relieved for seeing them departing to safety in their homes, I hope, because I have been linked with many of them through the last dreadful days. They were besieged in one of the supposedly one of the safest neighborhoods of our capital, which has been besieged by this fighting. And actually, most of the fighting took place around them. And it was, for me, a deep feeling of shame and feeling of embarrassment that those diplomats who have been here to connect between our countries and our people being besieged like this, having lack of water, having lack of food, having lack of security, having lack of access to medicine. Some of them had their granddaughter has been ill. So I am personally relieved that they, as diplomats, has been departed. But of course, as you mentioned, the departure of the diplomats means that we are totally, there is no watching over what is happening to Sudan, though all the channels are reporting. But also that for the first thing that took place after, for example, the American diplomats took place, departed, we got disconnected from the internet, from the major internet of the major supplier, Sudatel, which just returned 6 minutes now. But through this whole 40 hours of lack of connection, lack of knowing what is your beloved ones, because many of them are outside Sudan, and it was really very, very bad. So it means that now there is serious despair by the international community. Those two generals are totally lacking any wisdom to stop this nonsensical fighting over their own people. So the international community is taking their own citizens to safety, which is fair enough. But this means there is this sign of despair of any wisdom or any way to address things rationally. Now, it is totally apparent that the Sudanese people are being held hostage for the vindictive nature of both parties. And some of them are taking refuge, are using the Sudanese people as human shields. And yeah, others are not also saving them from the bombardment. So this is a very serious development. Another thing, the Sudanese people now, they are out of water for 10 days. I am one of the people who am supposed to be living in one of the, well, reasonably well neighborhood of the capital. We are totally out of water, no bath, no, we drink in a very hot weather now, in a calculated way. Let alone the bath and whatever. There is no whatever supply of food, no whatever supply of electricity. Now I am having electricity, a general electricity, but the problem is I don't have any access to buy new electricity if this runs out. So I am using now the least amount of electricity that is possible. And if it gets disconnected, I don't have any access to an alternative because the generators are run out of gasoline. And it is a really very dire situation. People now, they count the deaths.
Mariam, let me ask you this. In that case, you know, intermittent electricity, intermittent water, you have very little water, intermittent internet, as you were just saying there, against the backdrop of clearly, you know, a war between these two men, a battle between these two men, who neither of them prepared to give up power. What does that mean for Sudanese? What the decisions they have to make? Do they stay? do they go? We have seen some leaving. In your mind, are you seeing an exodus?
I tell you now, not less than 50% of the inhabitants of the capital, which is they are not less than 10 million, they are either displaced inside the homes of their relatives or the homes of their friends in a safer areas inside the capital, or left outside the capital, either northward, trying to reach out to Egypt or eastward to Port Sudan, or actually southward to Madani. This is the second largest city, or all the way to Rank to South Sudan.
Are you going to stay?
Yes, I am definitely. I am definitely staying, but I am telling you, we are now the daughters and son of Sadiq al-Mahdi. We are 10. Only 3 of us are staying in their homes. All the rest either displaced inside Sudan or already took refuge to other countries. So it is a total devastation to all the families. And if you ask now, we are exchanging news in the WhatsApp groups and so on. No single person had not affected directly, either by killing of his relative or her relatives, or displacement by himself or herself, or displacement of close families, or bombardment of their house and their housing, or wasting of their valuables. There is total devastation now. It is not only devastation, Isa. It is now. I have been listening to one of our prominent...
I'm just going to have to interrupt because we're running out of time. But we are extremely thankful for you taking the time to explain to us, give us a sense of what's happening on the ground. Please stay safe, Mariam. Thanks very much, Mariam Almahdi there, live for us in Khartoum in Sudan. And thank you for watching One World. I'm Isa Soares, Marketplace Africa.